Ready to get started?
Yes.
Let's do it. We see in all the languages that we visit tonight. Welcome, welcome, welcome to this very special event where we are going to do one night, one book, or one book, one night. It's one of those two things. And get it all started with a book that's very special to a lot of us, The Little Prince. It's part of our summer reading series, Imagine Your Story. You can see there on your screens, we have hcplc.org/summer. That is the key. That is the site that you need to go to find out about all of our summer reading offerings, which are still going on for a few more weeks, all the way up until July 31st. You can find out about other upcoming events, which we have starting Monday morning next week. We have prizes that you can be eligible for and digital badges that you can earn just by reading and logging your reading and participating in activities, which we'll mention again in just a moment. But we wanted to let those of you who are watching this live, awesome, you are part of the live experience. That means you can connect with us. That's right. There is a question section either of your go-to webinar control panel. If you're on a computer or your application, the question section, you can put in a question or a comment and just share your thoughts and ideas and queries with us. And we'll do our best to at least address some of those once we're done reading tonight. We also wanted to let you know there's going to be a brief survey right after the session. It's only a couple minutes long. Take a couple minutes and answer those questions so that not only can we hear your thoughts about tonight's very special event, but we can also help, that will help us plan for future events and see what you're interested in. So let's, you could win. Thank you, Melissa, for getting us to the next slide. A very important part of this tonight is stick with us throughout the session until the very end. And if you do, you will be eligible to win the Little Prince book in print, which means that's right. Just like you, thank you very much for the demonstration. And that way you can share it with your friends and your family members as well and read it. Every way I've read it is always a different, special, unique experience. So stay tuned to the end of the program so that you can be eligible to win that. Now, if you are watching this live and you have any difficulties with your technical abilities on your side, if you're having difficulty streaming the video, never fear, we are posting all of our summer reading videos on our YouTube channel for the library. That's Tampa Hillsborough County Public Library. And you will be able to view the video sometime next week. And actually, I'm put the cart before the horse. I should go ahead and say who we are. Since I said the name of our library system, I will say my name is Matthew.
And my name is Melissa. Je m'appelle Melissa.
Me llamo Amanda. My name is Amanda.
Oh, that's right. Mathieu or Mateo, one of the two. You can pick for me. So let's go on to the next thing, which is that this is crosses off a couple of boxes for the summer reading challenge. You can actually earn two different badges today. One is by borrowing the book. You can go on to Hoopla and borrow a copy of The Little Prince to read it tonight, read it all in one night. That's what the challenge is that we're putting forward to you. And there's also the Library Live Online event. You're doing it right now. Stick with us till the very end, and you can go on to the activity section of Beanstack, which is the place where you do all your reading challenge stuff, and you can get it from the summer reading website, the link there. And you can claim both of those badges in addition to being eligible to win the book. So now I'm going to kick it over to you guys.
All right. Thank you, Matthew. So as you guys know, the library is about books. It's about a whole bunch of other things, but it's also about books. We already said we love The Little Prince so much. You guys might also love it already, or this might be your first exciting time with it. One of the things we love about it so much is that The Little Prince is about seeing the world through the eyes of a child. So we're going to recommend a book for you that is all about creativity. You can find this book on Libby in our ebooks. It's called The Art of Noticing. Look up, then hire up. It's a practical guide to strengthen our imagination and not become a stuffy adult like the one the narrator of The Little Prince dislikes. So find happiness is engaging with the people, places, objects, and tasks we encounter every day. That's another book you might want to take a look at if you like The Little Prince and its message. And of course, the author of The Little Prince was also a fantastic human being in general. He was a winner of the Grand Prix of the Académie Française with this book, Wind, Sand, and Stars. And it captures the grandeur, danger, and isolation of flight. He was a pilot for his life, believe it or not. And it also provides some insight into his mindset and the philosophy of life that led him, a pilot who would go out in dangerous situations, to write a beloved classic for all ages. You can also check that one out on Libby. So feel free to check out either or both of these books if you guys are all about what The Little Prince is. All right? All right, I'm gonna kick it over to Amanda. She's gonna ask you maybe a question or two for you to share with us.
So we are going to be reading together tonight, and we want to remind you guys this, if you are watching live, this is an interactive experience. So we have a couple ways that you can interact with us. So the first one is we have some poll questions we're going to put up. So let's do a practice poll question first. So our first one is, a lot of people, maybe you're joining us tonight because you've always heard of The Little Prince and it's been on the top of your things to read list forever and you've never had a chance to get around to it. Or it is a beloved classic and maybe you love this book so much that you can't pass up an opportunity to do any reading of it and you'll always jump on board for that. So I'm gonna do our first poll question, and it is, so this is a practice, it's gonna come up on the screen and then you can type in your answer and we'll share the results. So our first question is, have you ever read The Little Prince? And you can just select yes or no. We'll give everybody a little bit of a chance to type in their answers there. And then what we'll go ahead and do is I'm going to close the poll. Don't worry if you didn't have a chance to answer. We're going to do another one. And then I'll show you. Let's see our readers tonight. Okay, Matthew, Melissa, it looks like we do have some returners, but we do have some newbies. So I'm glad that we can share this experience with everyone to read The Little Prince together. I really hope you enjoy it in all three languages. Now we're going to ask you a different question. So you can, there's two ways you can interact. You can answer the poll, but you can also give us some answers in the question section, and we'll come back and we'll read some of those a little bit later, because I don't know about you, Matthew and Melissa, but I am always looking for a good book recommendation. So our next question is, the theme of this program is one book, one night. So have you ever read a book that is so good that you read it in one sitting, that you could not put it down? So go ahead and answer the poll. And if you have read a book in one night, feel free to go into the question section and type in some of those books that you just are what we call unputdownable. So we're going to go ahead and close the poll and share the results. Okay. So it looks like quite a few of you have read a book in one sitting. So I really hope you do go into the questions section and you type, ooh, we've got a lot of good ones. So we will come back at the end of the broadcast and we'll share some of those books, book recommendations from you out there after we are done with the reading. So let me go ahead and hide the results. And for those of you who have not read one book in one night, I hope this is the first one you do. I hope you go to Hoopla and check it out and keep reading after we are done. Okay.
All right. Thank you so much, Amanda. Thank you guys for sharing in advance the books that you've read in one night. I think you can imagine a lot of us here at the library do like to read one book in one night quite often. So we're looking forward to getting more recommendations from you guys. All right. So here's what we're going to do now. And by the way, of course, you guys know, after we finish the reading of part of the book, you guys are going to go over to Hoopla and you're going to check out the book so that you can keep reading. We're going to read this in English, Spanish, and French. Mateo, or Mathieu, is going to start us off with English. Then Amanda is going to read the Spanish, Español, and I, Melissa, will read the French, okay? We're going to alternate as we go, and you might notice there are some words highlighted and some pictures as we go, so feel free to look at the screen and enjoy that. We also will turn off our camera while we're reading so you can just focus on the sound of our voice as we do our best to make some voices and what you're listening to, all right, guys? Ready? Okay.
All right.
Matthew, you can take it away.
Once, when I was six, I saw a magnificent picture in a book about the jungle called True Stories. It showed a boa constrictor swallowing a wild beast. Here is a copy of the picture. In the book, it said, boa constrictors swallow their prey whole without chewing. Afterward, they are no longer able to move, and they sleep during the 6 months of their digestion. In those days, I thought a lot about jungle adventures and eventually managed to make my first drawing using a colored pencil. My drawing number one looked like this. I showed the grown-ups my masterpiece, and I asked them if my drawing scared them. They answered, "Why be scared of a hat?" My drawing was not a picture of a hat. It was a picture of a boa constrictor digesting an elephant. Then I drew the inside of the boa constrictor so the grown-ups could understand. They always need explanations. My drawing number two looked like this.
Ooh. Now let's continue. You saw drawing in English, right? How do you say it in Spanish and French? You might want to pay attention to that as Amanda and I read next.
Okay, seguimos en español. Let's continue on in Spanish. Cuando tenía 6 años, vi en un libro sobre la selva virgen que se llamaba Historias Vividas, una imagen preciosa. Representaba una serpiente boa que se engullía una fiera. Esta es la copia del dibujo. El libro decía, las serpientes boa engullen su presa entera, sin masticarla. Después, como no pueden moverse, duermen durante los 6 meses durante la digestión. En ese momento, reflexioné mucho sobre las aventuras de la jungla y, al mismo tiempo, hice mi primer dibujo con un lápiz de color. Mi dibujo número uno era así. Enseñé mi obra de arte a las personas mayores y les pregunté si mi dibujo les daba miedo. Me respondieron, ¿por qué debería asustar un sombrero? Mi dibujo no representaba un sombrero. Representaba una serpiente boa que digiere un elefante. Dibujé entonces el interior de la serpiente boa para que las personas mayores no pudiesen entender. Siempre necesitan explicaciones. Mi dibujo número dos era así. So drawing is dibujo. Okay, Melissa, let's find out what it is in francés.
Okay. Lisons ensemble le premier chapitre. Lorsque j'avais 6 ans, j'ai vu une fois une magnifique image dans un livre sur la forêt vierge qui s'appelait Histoire vécue. Ça représentait un serpent boa qui avalait un fauve. Voilà la copie du dessin. On disait dans le livre, les serpents boa avalent leur proie tout entière. À la mâcher. Ensuite, ils ne peuvent plus bouger et ils dorment pendant les 6 mois de leur digestion. J'ai alors beaucoup réfléchi sur les aventures de la jungle et, à mon tour, j'ai réussi avec un crayon de couleur à tracer mon premier dessin, mon dessin numéro un. Il était comme ça. J'ai montré mon chef-d'œuvre aux grandes personnes et je leur ai demandé si mon dessin leur faisait peur. Elles m'ont répondu, pourquoi un chapeau ferait-il peur? Mon dessin ne représentait pas un chapeau. Il représentait un serpent boa qui digérait un éléphant. J'ai alors dessiné l'intérieur du serpent boa afin que les grandes personnes puissent comprendre. Elles ont toujours besoin d'explications. Mon dessin numéro 2 était comme ça. So the next section, you may have already noticed, there are already so many words that are similar. The next section has many words that remain similar in all three languages. I may have highlighted one or two as Mathieu continues in English.
The grown-ups advised me to put away my drawings of boa constrictors outside or inside and apply myself instead to geography, history, arithmetic, and grammar. That is why I abandoned at the age of 6 a magnificent career as an artist. I had been discouraged by the failure of my drawing number one and of my drawing number two. Grown-ups never understand anything by themselves, and it is exhausting for children to have to provide explanations over and over again. So then I had to choose another career, and I learned to pilot airplanes. I have flown almost everywhere in the world, and as a matter of fact, geography has been a big help to me. I could tell China from Arizona at first glance, which is very useful if you get lost during the night. So I've had, in the course of my life, lots of encounters with lots of serious people. I have spent lots of time with grown-ups. I have seen them at close range, which hasn't much improved my opinion of them. Whenever I encountered a grown-up who seemed to me at all enlightened, I would experiment on him with my drawing number one, which I have always kept. I wanted to see if he really understood anything, but he would always answer, "That's a hat." Then I wouldn't talk about boa constrictors or jungles or stars. I would put myself on his level and talk about bridge and golf and politics and neckties, and my grown-up was glad to know such a reasonable person.
Now, en español, con Amanda.
Gracias. Las personas mayores me aconsejaron que dejase de lado los dibujos de serpientes boas y fuesen abiertas o cerradas, y que pusiese más interés en la geografía, la historia, el cálculo y la gramática. De este modo, a la edad de 6 años, abandoné una magnífica carrera como pintor, descorazonado por el fracaso de mis dibujos número 1 y número 2. Las personas mayores nunca entienden nada por sí solas, y a los niños le cuesta tener que dar explicaciones todo el tiempo. Así pues, tuve que elegir otro trabajo y aprendí a pilotar aviones. He volado un poco por todo el mundo, y la verdad es que la geografía me ha servido de mucho. Con un solo vistazo puedo distinguir entre las tierras de China y las de Arizona. Esto es muy útil, sobre todo si uno se pierde durante la noche.
Ok, je vais continuer en français. Oh, sorry, still Amanda.
Oh. Una página más, por favor.
Una página más.
Cuando me encontraba con alguna persona que parecía inteligente, la ponía a la prueba con mi dibujo número 1, que siempre he guardado. Quería saber si realmente lo entendía, pero la respuesta era siempre la misma. ¿Es un sombrero? Me absentía entonces de hablarles de serpientes boas, de la selva virgen y de las estrellas. Me olvidaba de mi mundo y le hablaba del suyo, de bridge, de golf, de políticas y de corbatas. Y esa persona mayor se sentía muy contenta de conocer a un hombre tan razonable.
Ok, en francés maintenant. Les grandes personnes m'ont conseillé de laisser de côté les dessins de serpents boa ouverts ou fermés et de m'intéresser plutôt à la géographie, à l'histoire, au calcul et à la grammaire. C'est ainsi que j'ai abandonné, à l'âge de 6 ans, une magnifique carrière de peintre. J'avais été découragée par l'insuccès de mon dessin numéro 1 et de mon dessin numéro 2. Les grandes personnes ne comprennent jamais rien toutes seules. Et c'est fatigant pour les enfants de toujours et toujours leur donner des explications. J'ai donc dû choisir un autre métier et j'ai appris à piloter des avions. J'ai volé un peu partout dans le monde et la géographie, c'est exact, m'a beaucoup servi. Je savais reconnaître du premier coup d'œil la Chine de l'Arizona. C'est très utile si l'on est égaré pendant la nuit. J'ai ainsi eu, au cours de ma vie, des tas de contacts avec des tas de gens sérieux. J'ai beaucoup vécu chez les grandes personnes. Je les ai vus de très près. Ça n'a pas trop amélioré mon opinion. Quand j'en rencontrais une qui me paraissait un peu lucide, je faisais l'expérience sur elle de mon dessin numéro 1 que j'ai toujours conservé. Je voulais savoir si elle était vraiment compréhensive. Mais toujours elle me répondait, C'est un chapeau. Alors, je ne lui parlais ni de serpent boa, ni de forêt vierge, ni d'étoiles. Je me mettais à sa portée. Je lui parlais de bridge, de golf, de politique et de cravate. Et la grande personne était bien contente de connaître un homme aussi raisonnable. Matthew is now going to read again to you in English, and the next section has one animal with three very different words, unlike this section where you saw a lot of similar words.
So, I lived all alone without anyone I could really talk to until I had to make a crash landing in the Sahara Desert 6 years ago. Something in my plane's engine had broken, and since I had neither a mechanic nor passengers in the plane with me, I was preparing to undertake the difficult repair job by myself. For me, it was a matter of life or death. I only had enough drinking water for 8 days. The first night, then, I went to sleep on the sand 1,000 miles from any inhabited country. I was more isolated than a man shipwrecked on a raft in the middle of the ocean. So you can imagine my surprise when I was awakened at daybreak by a funny little voice saying, "Please, draw me a sheep." What? Draw me a sheep. I leaped up as if I had been struck by lightning. I rubbed my eyes hard. I stared. And I saw an extraordinary little fellow staring back at me very seriously. Here is the best portrait I managed to make of him later on. There's the little prince. All right, Amanda.
Okay, we will continue. O como decimos, el principito. Okay, capítulo dos. Así he vivido, solo, sin nadie con quien poder hablar verdaderamente. Hasta hace 6 años, cuando mi aeroplano tuve una avería en el desierto del Sahara. Algo se había estropeado en el motor de mi avión y, como no me acompañaba ningún mecánico u otros pasajeros, me dispuse, yo solo, a realizar una reparación muy difícil. Para mí era una cuestión de vida o muerte, ya que apenas me quedaba agua para aplacar mi sed durante unos 8 días. La primera noche me quedé dormido sobre la arena a 1,000 millas de cualquier lugar habitado. Estaba más aislado que un náufrago en el medio del océano. Entonces, se pueden imaginar mi sorpresa cuando, al amanecer, me despertó una vocecita muy graciosa que decía, "Por favor, dibújame un cordero." ¿Eh? Dibújame un cordero. De un brinco me puse de pie como si me hubiese alcanzado un rayo. Me froté los ojos y me miré detenidamente. Descubrí a un extraordinario muchachito que me observaba fijamente. He aquí el mejor retrato que logré hacer más tarde de él. Y aquí al revés es el retrato del principito.
On continue en français. Chapitre 2. J'ai ainsi vécu seul, sans personne avec qui parler véritablement, jusqu'à une fin dans le désert du Sahara, il y a 6 ans. Quelque chose s'était cassé dans mon moteur, et comme je n'avais avec moi ni mécanicien ni passager, je me préparais à essayer de réussir toute seule une réparation difficile. C'était pour moi une question de vie ou de mort. J'avais à peine de l'eau à boire pour 8 jours. Le premier soir, je me suis donc endormie sur le sable à 1,000 milles de toute terre habitée. J'étais bien plus isolée qu'un naufragé sur un radeau au milieu de l'océan. Alors, vous imaginez ma surprise au lever du jour, quand une drôle de petite voix m'a réveillée. Elle disait, « S'il vous plaît, dessine-moi un mouton. » « Hein ?»« Dessine-moi un mouton. » J'ai sauté sur mes pieds comme si j'avais été frappée par la foudre. J'ai bien frotté mes yeux, j'ai bien regardé et j'ai vu un petit bonhomme tout à fait extraordinaire qui me considérait gravement. Voilà le meilleur portrait que plus tard, j'ai réussi à faire de lui. Voilà le petit prince. So here's the little prince, the last time you'll see him today, until you go and check out your book, and a little preview of the sheep, or cordero, or mouton, that you guys will see as you continue your reading tonight. Okay, we hope that you enjoyed that. That's all we're going to read together. Of course, please, please check it out by yourself and keep reading it tonight. I know I definitely will. This is an all-time classic that I've read many times already. For people who want something a little bit more, but maybe not another book to read, we do have some other library resources for you. So one thing that's very fun to do is to use our Gale Literature Resource Center, and you can find it on hcplc.org in the research section for literature. They have a lot of biographical information about some major authors. The articles are very well written and interesting, and there's just a wealth of information. So do feel free to check that out. And we also have for you guys in the handout section on the side of your screen where your control panel is, you'll see that it says one handout. We do have a PDF for you guys to make a rose craft inspired by the rose character in The Little Prince. And that's someone that you'll be meeting later on. And I'm gonna turn on my camera just so that you guys see. I have definitely made these flowers myself. They are very fun and easy to make. And we are nearing the end of our program. So we hope you check out those additional resources. I'm going to invite Matthew and Amanda also to turn on their cameras too as we finish up and say goodbye.
Oh, another character.
Oh, how do you say that in English?
Another preview from the book you will read tonight.
Before we move on, we do want, I think one thing we did fail to point out is we have more than one digital ebook service. And so one of the benefits that you can go to our Overdrive page and download the Overdrive or Libby app. And you can also go to our Hoopla page, which are all on our ebooks page. They're different ones. One of the very cool things about Hoopla is there is never any waits. Everybody can check out the same book at the same time. So if you are all looking to get a copy and you don't want to be put on the wait list and you really want to finish it tonight, I would definitely recommend you can go to Hoopla, but you can also find it in Overdrive. And we were just talking about the handout section. So it looks like before we move on, Matthew, I do want to read. Some people did give us some book recommendations for one book in one night. And it looks like we have some good ones out there that I do recognize some of these titles from our both our digital and physical collection. One is The Land of Stories. The other is the Dogman series, which is very popular. We are very familiar with that one. Another very popular series we all know and love are Dork Diaries. Those fly off the shelves. We have quite a few copies of those. And there are several books in both of those series. Oh, somebody read the whole series of Unfortunate Events by Lemony Snicket in one sitting. So that is quite a sitting. Good, yes, good job, good job. But when we say unputdownable, okay. And then the last one is Love Story, which could just be a genre of stories that are hard to put down, or it could be the book Love Story that was the basis for the movie Love Story. We do
I
not.
I think
know.
I read that book in one night, actually. So.
That's it is a novella, so it could very well be that book that and we have just a couple more. We have several entries for Diary of a Wimpy Kid, and then we also have The Alchemist by Paulo Coelho, which is also a novella and also very much like The Little Prince. If you like that, you might like this, grappling with different ideas and existentialism and those sort of things. So thank you for sharing those with us.
Yes, thank you very much. And we wish we could read all the titles that are being recommended because there's a long list of them. But I'll give a quick shout out to somebody recommended the Ramona series by Beverly Cleary, which is an 8-book series. And I read those to my I read them when I was a kid, and I read them to my kids. And that's really a special one for sure. I'll share very quickly that the first book I think I ever read in one sitting besides The Little Prince, because I think The Little Prince was among the first, was the Michael Crichton book, Jurassic Park, which was the basis for the movie series. And I think there's a few of the books actually that have been published, but that was just one of those, like, couldn't put it down books that was really just very fun to read. And I haven't revisited it since, but I think maybe I will, and then just thought of it. So, but yeah, do you think?
Speaking of those action adventure ones that are very cinematic, we just got one for The Hunger Games, which is much like kind of the Michael Crichton books, is very, it gets you hooked and there's a lot of action and adventure. And Matthew, I'm glad we had a couple come in late. So we did get the Ramona, which I, if you, all of the Beverly Cleary, the Ramona books, all of hers are so, you've got the Mouse on the Motorcycle, you've got Ellen Tebbets, you've got so many good ones. Some of my favorite ones are Dear Mr. Henshaw and its sequel Strider. So if you love those, and then something, a call out to my youth, which is now having a comeback, is the Babysitter's Club. So those are available, the originals. They're original and graphic novel now, and I think Netflix or somebody's putting out even a show now. So if you want to, those are very, yeah, those could be one sitting as well.
Oh,
So definitely.
those were many, many nights of one sitting books, those Babysitter Club books. And the new series is excellent. I was actually just rereading some of those books last night. So it's funny you mentioned that, guys. Check out the Babysitter's Club books. Those are certified unputdownable per Amanda, Melissa, and many, many other kids. So
Let's advance to the next slide if we could, Melissa, while we answer a
sure.
couple of the questions. One of the
Okay.
first questions that came in is, will the 1000 Books Before Kindergarten be available after the end of July? For those of you who've not seen it, and for those of you who have young children in your life in some way, you may be already taking advantage of the summer reading challenge on Beanstack. But there's also another challenge, 1000 Books Before Kindergarten, that's available. And yes, the answer is yes, we'll definitely be continuing it through the end of the calendar year. Probably it will be a permanent initiative that we will keep up, is my best guess. Actually, Melissa is on our literacy team, and she'll be among the people helping to support that. But yeah, the answer is yes. We should have that for some time, I believe, at least through the end of the calendar year. And then the other question that came in, we addressed it a little bit earlier, but for those of you who came in late, all of our summer reading videos we're posting on our YouTube channel, and that's for the Tampa Hillsborough County Public Library. And so sometime next week, you should be able to view this video. If you missed any part of it, or you want to share it with a friend or a family member, please do. We love for the program to live on after that. Okay, we could go on and on about the book titles that keep coming in. So, but we have to move on. You'll see that you've got some contact information in front of you. If you have difficulty downloading the craft, or if you have any questions that you want to ask us that we didn't get time to address, please get in contact with us by the phone, or you see that there's a website there, hcplc.org/about/contact. Not only can you send us messages there, but you can also do a chat with our Ask a Librarian service. And there's the summer reading website that you should definitely go and check out if you can. Let's see. I don't want to make any false promises, but I believe most, if not all of you who attended tonight will be eligible to win that free print book. So make sure you check your email, the email that you use to log in tonight and that you used to register for this program. Check that email, because that is how we will be contacting you in order to get you your free copy of the book. And there's one more thing we want to do, because we're asking you to take part in this really fun initiative and read one book in one night. We want to hear about your experience, either with that or anything else that you're doing related to the library this summer. I just posted the link in the chat. hcplc.org/about/stories. You can also get to that link from the summer reading website at the very top. But we want to hear from you. Take a picture of you reading it, or just share what your experience was like, either reading that or something else. And we really love to hear all about those things, because in this time it's very difficult to make those connections with one another. And this is one way that I think we can stay connected. And we really, really appreciate you guys joining us tonight. And I think it's time to sign off. So what I'm going to say is, may the pages of your book be lit by millions of stars tonight.
Well, I will just say adios y que tengas un buenos fin de semana y que lee mucho.
I will say bonne chance and bonne nuit. Thank you guys so much for joining us.
Thank you, everybody.